Hello YouTube and welcome to another video from Tech with Stefan. Today I'm going to review the Samsung Galaxy S20 Fun Edition. And we have here the device, and it has a very nice orange color. It's Orange Cloud, the name of the color you see here. And it's a pretty nice matte finish on the back. And this is made of plastic, of course, but it's a very good quality plastic. Okay, so let's first take a look at the box. And let's do a small unboxing to see what we have here inside the box. There is some paperwork regarding the manual and the warranty here. And you have the SIM ejector tool here. And here are the booklets regarding your phone. Quick start guide. Let's just put it aside. And what's else in the box? There is of course a charger. This is a fast charger from Samsung. And it has 15 watts of power. Let's put this aside, and of course there is the USB type C to USB type A charging cable, which is good to connect to the power charger for AC. That's about it, what you get in the box, nothing else as you can see here. And let's just put this all aside. Okay, let's take a closer look at the device. And you can see here on the back we have three cameras, and there is the normal wide camera with optical stabilization, 3x optical zoom, of course with optical stabilization, and the ultra wide, no stabilization there. But this has almost the same cameras as the Galaxy S21, and the size of the phone and the hardware feels very much indeed with the S21 Plus. So you can compare this directly to that phone. Keep in mind the only difference in between them, it's the main processor, which is a bit newer on the S21 Plus. While the S20 FE edition has, let's say, a bit weaker CPU, but you'll see everyday today use is no difference, big difference. And taking a closer look, you can see here the metal, which is the frame, it's all made of metal and it's very good quality. And even the back, which is, let's say, a matte plastic, feels very good in the hand. It doesn't squeak, it's IP68. Water resistant, and the build quality feels very good on this phone. And you can see here on the front we have the punch hole camera, and of course this has an always on display as you can see here. And there is a fingerprint scanner, there is a fingerprint scanner, and you can unlock using your fingerprint like that, and it is pretty fast. And taking a closer look at the hardware, we can see here the speaker, USB type C, and the microphone. Here we have no buttons. On top we have the SIM ejector tool. Let's take a closer look at how it handles the SIMs. And as you can see, there are SIM 2 or micro SD, and the other SIM, which is here. So this is what you get. Let's put it back. And of course the microphone hole, and here on the left side we have the power buttons and the volume rockers. That's about it with the hardware. Let's take a closer look at the screen. And this is a 120Hz full HD AMOLED screen, and it has a very nice aspect ratio, and the edges are not curved like previous Galaxy devices. And as you can see, they are flat, and this makes it, from my opinion, a little better than having it with round edges. You can see better the screen, and you don't get the screen warping the image when you're getting to the edges. So from my opinion, I think this is the best. This is what they've done with the S21 as well. So this was, let's say, a bit of ahead of its time, because it's only S20 Fan Edition, but the same screen you can find on the S21 line. So yeah, keep that in mind. This is a very good and cheaper alternative to the normal S21 Plus. And of course the cameras you will see in my review, they are very very good. And I have also compared them with the iPhone 12, and they are very very good. And I think because you get the 3x optical zoom, you can compare them actually with iPhone 12 Pro, which is a lot more expensive than this one. This was around, let's say, $400 or euros, and iPhone 12 Pro, it's like $1,000 or euros, and yeah, it's a lot better. Okay, let's take a closer look at the software, and as you can see here, let's go to the settings, about phone, and as you can see here, it has the One UI 3.1 Android 11, and it has the latest February 1st patch here. So basically all it's updated, and it's on par with the S21 versions, so the software experience is almost the same. And from my opinion the software works pretty well. You cannot get any glitches from what I have tested it so far, and it does support a lot of features like night mode, as you can see here, and a lot of toggles that you can have here and play with it. And this is the dark mode, and of course it has also reverse wireless charging, and for that you can, let's say, charge your iPhone for example, and this is ready to charge. And right now, if I'm connecting my iPhone on top of the Samsung, you will see it's charging. So that's a pretty nice feature that they implemented in the Galaxy S20 Fan Edition also. You can charge your iPhone wirelessly with your Galaxy phone. This is something which I will call amazing. It's another kind of power sharing, and you don't need any cable. This is done wireless, and as you can see, it's still charging. So this is a very nice feature that I would like to see on other phones. For example, like iPhones, they do not have this feature. So yeah, that's just one feature that you can have on the Galaxy S20 Fan Edition. Okay, let's take a closer look at the performance. And for that, I have used Geekbench 5 to test it. And you can see here the specifications of the phone. And let's take a closer look at the history. I have run it many times, as you can see here. And let's say the last good performance was this one. You can see the single score 899, which is comparable with the S20 Ultra, which has the same CPU almost. This is the Snapdragon 865, while this Samsung has the Exynos 990. So keep that in mind. And the multi-score is 2609, which is a bit slower than the Snapdragon 865. But it's on par with the Galaxy S20 with the Exynos 990. So yeah, performance is very good with Geekbench 5 at least. And let's compare this also with AnTuTu benchmark. I have run this also on the iPhone that I have. And let's take a closer look. The score of the iPhone, you can see here. This is the iPhone 11 that I am using. And the score is about the same. If we take a closer look, you can see the CPU is actually better on the S20 Fan Edition. The GPU of course is better on the iPhone, but yeah, memory and UI, it's almost better than the iPhone here. So yeah, keep in mind, you can compare this with the iPhone 11, and it's pretty good, I will say. And keep in mind, temperature was 7.9 degrees higher from starting to the end, and 4% battery drop. A storage test. Let's take a closer look and see the storage speeds. And we can compare this with the iPhone. You can see it's a lot slower, the iPhone 11, than the S20. Almost twice the difference. So keep that in mind, this is a very fast phone, and I will say for the price of it, 440, let's say, dollars or euros, it's also beating my iPhone 11 on the cameras, the speed, and everything else. And you can see the iPhone 11 has only two cameras, normal wide and ultra wide. It has no telephoto 3x zoom in, and of course they are both water resistant, but the iPhone cannot power share like you have this on the S20. So yeah, in my opinion, I think S20 Fan Edition, it's a bit better than the iPhone 11 at least. And it's also comparable with the cameras on the iPhone 12. You will see that review in another video. Please
Okay,
let's talk about the cameras. So we have here on the back three cameras: the normal wide, ultra wide, and the 3x optical zoom camera. And they are very good cameras, I would say. The last of them have optical stabilization. This is a shop, and I think it's gathering all the information inside pretty well with the reflection of the lights also. But please stay tuned and subscribe to my channel to see the videos, and there are a lot of pictures taken into the daytime. Here it's with the zoom, ultra wide, flower, and all of that pictures you can see in my comparison video with the iPhone 12. So yeah, my conclusion is S20 Fan Edition, it's a very good phone, solid cameras. I would say they are even better than the iPhone 12 and comparable with the iPhone 12 Pro, which is twice as much than this one. And I will also say that it's better than the S21 because it's only half that price. And in my book, that counts very much because you will change your phone, let's say, once or... So yeah, please give the S20 Fan Edition with 5G that has a better CPU than this one, and it's not heating as much. As you can see, it's reaching 50 degrees without doing anything, just staying idle. So yeah, the phone is very, very good, cameras are very nice, but the CPU with the 4G model, it's pretty, let's say, hot, and not in a good way, but it's just getting hot doing nothing, you see, 50 degrees, and I'm not doing anything in the background. So yeah, my opinion, this is a very good phone, but the 5G option is the one to get because it has the cooler CPU from Qualcomm. And the performance on this one, it's on par with iPhone 11, which is quite high, and I will say it's very, very good offer for half the price of that one also. So yeah, thank you for watching, and please like, share, and subscribe to see more awesome videos like this one. Until next time, have a great day. Bye bye.